Every day, I dread getting up because pushing myself out of bed each morning is the hardest part of my day. I'm always worried about my ankles giving out and collapsing because my joints and muscles barely sustain my weight. My body has reached a point that I can't even go a few steps without being winded. Because I'm the size of five people in one body, my weight makes everything hard. When I see myself in a picture or in a mirror, you almost would think, like, shouldn't that be enough to just stop and realize what it is you're doing? But I get so depressed by it that I go to what is the most comforting, which is food. And as far back as I can remember, food has always been what has consoled me. Food makes me so happy that just seeing it and smelling it starts to help me feel better and helps with my anxiety. I feel like food is the one thing that doesn't judge you. It never lets me down and never disappoints me. It fills a void and emptiness inside me. Eating donuts for me can be described as a sexual experience almost, because it is like, it's so fulfilling and it's satisfying. And to be able to eat and enjoy this alone with nobody watching is the best part of my day. But once I start, I can't stop. And unfortunately, my addiction to food has only gotten worse over the years. Never in my life did I think this is where I would end up, at 600 pounds. I started to put on weight at a young age. My childhood was very chaotic. I remember feeling like our family was different than others, because it was my mom that worked to support our family of four, and my dad would go out to the bars drinking. So he wasn't really around much and didn't participate in our daily lives. And I felt like my mom was angry and had a lot of resentment towards him. So when he would come home, there was always a lot of fighting. And sometimes it would get loud and violent. And if it weren't for my Grandma Faye, I wouldn't have had anyone, because she's really who I feel like raised me and took care of me. And when my parents would fight, she would try to distract me with ice cream. And I remember how it made me feel better. And so sugar became the thing in my life with my grandmother that I knew could make me feel better when I was afraid or upset. And by the time I was 7, I was around 160 pounds. My mom began to hear from family and friends that there was something wrong with me, that I have a problem. And she felt like I made her look bad as a mother. So she would scream at me for eating and told me I was getting too fat.
I started to worry about Alicia's weight in grade school. You would hear remarks from other people and wonder, maybe I should be more worried than I am. I thought maybe she would outgrow it, but she didn't.
So my eating just got worse because I was more depressed and I kept going. And I hit 200 pounds by the time I was 10. And that's when my life came crashing down. My Grandma Faye was diagnosed with lung cancer, and I'd go to visit her daily in the hospital. But then one day, I could tell she was getting worse. She was hooked up to more and more wires. It freaked me out. And I left without saying goodbye to her. She passed away that night. She was the person I most loved, and I didn't get to say goodbye. I was shattered, but I had no one at that point. My mom was embarrassed by me, and my dad was barely around, and the only person who had loved me was gone. And eating not only helped me with the pain, but it made me feel like my grandma was back with me, because that's what we shared together. So I would begin sneaking food at night. I didn't want my mom to see how much I was eating because she was already embarrassed of me. And I was eating constantly. So I gained another 80 pounds over the next 2 years. And I was getting close to 300 pounds by the time I was 14. Before I went to bed, I would pray that I would wake up skinny, but I was always the same fat kid in the morning. My mom was so ashamed, she put me in a weight loss club. I was really angry at my mom that she made me go to those meetings. And she would say, "I don't want to go to this either. I'm doing this for you." But they started to think that the only thing that mattered to my mom was my weight. I was just a number and no longer a person. And by the time I was 18, I was over 400 pounds. But my weight never held me back then. I still had friends and I'd still go out. I even dated. But then at the end of my senior year, a male friend who I had always had a crush on came over and we started messing around. And I eventually told him to stop and he didn't stop. And he raped me. I felt just really weak and helpless. And also, I felt a lot of shame. I felt like I had no one to turn to. Who's gonna believe me? Who's gonna believe that he raped you? Because why would he want to? Fat girls don't get raped. And so I hid what happened from everyone. And I did what I knew. I ate to deal with the pain. When I was 20, my weight got to over 500 pounds, and I was no longer able to function like a normal person.
This is not the life I wanted her to have. I wanted her to be happy and active and healthy. Sometimes you lose control of what's going on, and you don't realize it until it's too late.
So I dropped out of college and gave up my dream of being a kindergarten teacher. I felt like a complete failure. I felt like I was never going to have a fulfilling life. And I was contemplating suicide often. It would be my escape from all the disappointments. I was tired of feeling like a failure to my mom, to my family, and to myself. And the pain and struggle was becoming too much. And I just wanted to end it. And I think I would have done that, but that's when I met Tim. We met 6 years ago and we connected quickly because we were both addicts. He was addicted to drugs. And so he understood my addiction to food and didn't judge me.
When Alicia and I first met, what I did notice was just her carefree spirit, her laugh, and her size didn't bother me, and I really liked being with her because she was always laughing and smiling. But now it's almost like she's a totally different person. And our relationship has grown stagnant. And as time goes on, Alicia doesn't want to do hardly anything at all. She just wants to sit in front of the TV and eat, which really frustrates me because we have a life to live together.